Alright, welcome to another episode of TroysTube. What I'm going to go over here is how to install a new version of BLHeli, which is 16.65. The 6.5, the version 5 of it, is a custom firmware version of this, which has startup tones, and you can change them to be like most popular ones, like the Imperial March. I'm going to cover this in this video. Right now, I'm actually using the older version of BLHeli Suite. Yeah, there's a newer one out. This one didn't work, and that might be because I'm using it on a 90GT, which is a micro quad. I'm not too sure exactly what it is, but this video should be useful for almost all quads out there for the most part. So what I'm going to do is plug in the USB port to the flight controller right now as we speak. I'm just going to plug that in. Okay, now we hear Windows connecting to it. And then I'm going to plug in power. But before I do that, you just remove the props. Please do not have the props on. I cannot stress that enough. Take the props off. I've had it where I've seen it fly up and hit my my computer monitor and my wind. I've been there and done that before, so just heed my warning. Okay, gonna plug it in. Props are off. You can hear the startup tone. I already have this done. That's Imperial March, and these beeps right now are telling me I have DShot enabled. Okay, so now how do we do this? So basically, I want to make sure that I'm gonna use clean flight. This SID Labs right here, SID Labs, is pretty much the most common one here. ATML MELs, I think, is more for older models with older BLHeli or older hardware. This one works for me. I know that because now I'm going to click connect. I make sure that it's the right port though, and use the same port wherever you use in Betaflight, and use the same baud rates. Let's go ahead and connect. Oh, okay, guess not, man. Oh, you know why? Error, user error, Betaflight is still open. Let's disconnect that bad boy and close that. Okay, that's an ID10T error. If anyone in IT, you will know what that means. All right, let's go ahead and connect it now. All right, let me go ahead now. I'm going to click check. Check's going to tell me, boom, 3, 4 ESCs. We're good. I got my master, and the rest are all slaves. And now it's going to switch over. Okay, and now how do we flash the custom version of that? Well, first of all, just make sure you did download it from the actual site. I found mine here. And by the way, I'm going to post all the links below. So this is where I download the actual zip file, and I extracted it to my local machine. And then before I click flash BLHeli, just make sure you go in the ESC overview. This is going to tell you the exact values you have now. And what I would do is use a snipping tool here and just take a screenshot of all that, right? So now this tells me these are the previous values I have on here before. So then I know if I go and flash and any of these are different, I know how I can go back from that. Because once you flash it, and if it does change, I think BLHeli does the most part saves them, but if it doesn't, you're going to be pissed that you didn't have something to go off of. So, okay, so let's go back to the ESC setup here. And now I'm going to flash BLHeli. And it's going to load one that's the newer, like BLHeli 16.6. This is loaded with the actual application. But what I'm going to say is ignore this. I'm way better than that. Oh, another thing. When I went to go check these, actually, it was right there. There's the actual version, which is CH50. Remember that. Okay, it also says that here, like an idiot. So let's go ahead, and we're going to go back and flash BLHeli and ignore the list, and I'm going to find the one from my custom folder I had. This is where I put it on my local machine. I named it Hex, and I can tell it's 16.5. Let's find the CX50 one. That's it. Now, some other quads might have different names, like Afro or something like that, and it will have actually the amperage rating on that. Make sure it just matches what's ever there. So if it's 12 amp, don't flash 20 amp unless you do your research, okay? I've actually done that. I've had no problems, but just make sure you do your research. Some ESCs are rated at 20 amp, and they come factory with lower amperage. I don't know if that's a mistake, something like that. So I don't know if the biggest difference it makes, but I had that problem, whatever. I flashed it, it was fine, but do your research. But now we're going to go with this version exactly right here, CH50, that's already loaded. I'm going to open it. Now this gets pretty scary. You're like, oh my God, what you doing, bro? This ain't right, man. Don't do this, you're going to kill it. Just relax. Just go ahead and click yes. Okay, now it's like, warning, now you have porn on your computer and we're installing virus. Well, okay, besides that, you really don't. But just go ahead and click yes. Remember, just make sure you're confident it's the same version that you are going to install. Click yes. It's going to flash. Now, some quads, it might like crash right around here, and you don't freak out like, oh my God, what did you do, man? See, not responding. It's cool. Relax. Just let it do its thing. Don't touch it. Don't disconnect anything. All right, now it says successfully. That's what we want to know. So then you flash one. Okay, now you can move on to doing other ones. It says, do you want to write the current setting to ESC 1? Yes, it's going to hopefully carry over my same settings. It might give you a warning, too, that you want to rename this. The name's fine. It's in the ESC overview. Now we have to do the same process again, though. This is kind of annoying. Now it says target ESC number 2. We were doing number 144. You have to do the same thing over and over again. This is a little frustrating. But make sure you select the right file again. Remember, Flash BLHeli, take the same list. Check the same list of files, but make sure you take the same actual hex file and do it again. And this is just repeats the same steps I go over and over again until you do all four. And then when you're done, just take, see here's a name. It doesn't matter. It's just startup tones. But make sure that your settings match what you had before. Just do a 101 like, all right, now I'm good to go. And I know that this actually worked. Also then, now, in order to change the actual beep tones of the startup, you want to change the beep strength, and you want to just go off of what is actually here in the website. Again, I'll post these links below, but the beeps tone, beep strength here, the Imperial March is 91. I have it set to 91. You can do the standard one, which is default, and it's doo-doo-doo-doo-dee. Yeah, but you're not as cool, man. You want to be like, yo, man, I'm freaking an Imperial, man. Darth Vader is my dad. What? And then you got Game of Thrones or Game of Tones, if you're a Futurama fan. Shut up, baby, I know it. And then another tip here, if you're in the 90 GT, if you're using micro quad, you don't have a buzzard, set the beacon strength to 130, which is powerful. I got that recommendation from Mark. And my personal recommendation of mine is to set the beacon delay to 1. I've covered that in my other videos of setting up this micro drone. A lot of cool things. And then you just, when you set these values, 91, you just write, make sure that these are all enabled. Whatever you have here clicked on will write to those. So if I just did like 1 and 2 and I had like motors 2 and 3 reverse, 6 or something like that, I would reverse them. We're not, you know, don't do that. But we're enabled all these 3s and we're going to write setup. And it's going to say nothing right because it's already updated. But it would say, like, hey, you wrote these values. Cool. All right. Now that's pretty much it. And now we're going to just do some validation here. Let's disconnect it because I'm going to go over like how you set up DShot. So disconnect this bad boy. I should hear the startup tone coming. Which is good. That means great success. We're going to close this guy boy out. And what I want to do now is just go into my apps and open up Betaflight, not CleanFlight. Okay, let's go ahead and connect. And for those of you that want to set up DShot, here's your DShot options. I suggest starting with 150, 300, 600, but I think everything by now, especially if you have an F3 board, SPF Racing F3, you should be good to go with DShot 600. And what I want to do is just make sure that the motors start up to make sure everything's fine. Again, take the props off. Don't make me come over your house and smack you with a prop and make your finger all bloody, because I've seen people that have suffered from this. So please, be my friend and do me a favor. All right, that's disabled, and we're just going to slowly raise the throttle up. Whoa, 88 miles per hour, 1.1 gigawatts. Look at it, I'm racing, guys. You hear all, oh, my God, I'm hitting those gates. Oh, my God, gravity gate. Oh, crashed. Okay, so that is pretty much to it. That's covering everything. Everything is good to go. At this point, I'm going to wrap up the video. So if you did like this video, please scroll down below and give me a thumbs up. I really appreciate that. And also consider subscribing in the top right corner or the bottom right corner, as I make videos that kind of help you guys out. They go over some things, showing you cool techs and gadgets. Also doing some kind of fun skits. I basically just like to teach people and actually, you know, entertain people. So I really appreciate if you subscribe and also enable notifications on my channel. You would be doing me a huge favor. I couldn't tell you how much that means to me. So again, please consider subscribing, and I'm going to wrap it up at this point saying that I hope you liked what you watched here. I hope you learned something and you were entertained for the most part. If not, I'll give you your money back in the mail. Just send me your address. That's how it works. Okay, Troy and TroysTube, thanks for watching. Take care.